morning. We want to welcome you guys all this morning for service this morning. It is a blessing to be alive and well. It's a blessing to be here this morning. I'm excited for a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful morning this morning. I want to wish all the fathers that are watching, all of you fathers out there, happy Father's Day on behalf of myself, my lovely wife and family and the ministry. Happy Father's Day. Let me tell you, it is a blessing to be alive this morning. It is a blessing to really, truly be able to get up this morning, see your loved ones. It is a blessing to get up this morning and smell and taste, and you can see and you can still feel. It's a blessing. And you know, one of the things I was just listening to that song, being reminded that, you know, we are under and over heaven, but also being reminded that we have the greatest Father of all. And the greatest Father of all is God Almighty, you know? And it's amazing. And when I say amazing, it is amazing to see and to really be able to understand how great of a Father we truly have. The one and only Father, right? The great I Am, the brighter morning star. He is the lily of the valley. There is no one like him. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I don't know about you, but I'm excited to be able to get up this morning to wish the greatest Father happy Father's Day. You know, the Father that, you know, made us in his own likeness and in his own image. The Father that blesses us even when we don't deserve it. He blesses us unconditionally. And you know, before we begin and we start the message today, I want to play another song for praise and worship. So one more song. And I pray that even right now, that as you're about to listen to this wonderful song, that you would just worship and praise the Lord God Almighty in spirit and in truth. The Bible says that when we praise and worship, we must praise and worship him in spirit and in truth. There's something about our praises and our worship. There's something about blocking our neighbor out and blocking our loved ones out for that split few minutes. And there's just something about worshiping in spirit and in truth. And the Bible says it, that when we worship the Lord in spirit and in truth, guess what happens? Healings begin to take place. Deliverance begin to take place. Bondage is broken. And it happens all when we are praising and worshiping the Lord. You don't need the pastor to go there and preach. Oh no, you don't need that. Why? Because even in praise and worship, in itself, it's bringing glory to the Almighty God. And when we are praising and worshiping the Lord, guess what happens? You get to really see the fullness of God and his power. And when we all come together as one and we are worshiping the Lord God Almighty, and we are worshiping the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, and we are worshiping him, and we're giving him all the glory, I'm telling you, you begin to feel his power, and you begin to feel his might. And his mighty hand, I'm telling you, his mighty hand is moving in this place. I don't know about you, I don't know who you are, or where you are, or what you're doing right now, but today is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I want you to get ready as we worship the Lord. God Almighty, you are holy. We worship you. Oh, we magnify you, Lord. Come on, someone just worship the Lord. Worship him this morning. Worship him even in this place. Worship him in this place. Hallelujah. Whatever you're doing right now, just worship him and just thank you. Lord.
Oh, God, oh, God.
Hallelujah.
Everything, everything, everything. forevermore.
We understand. We understand. Not like you. Not like you. And we raise our holy shoes. That's it. This is what it is tonight.
Jesus said this. Jesus says, no man can go to the Father except through through me, even Jesus Christ, the Son of the Almighty God, understood the importance of his Father and understood that without his Father, there could not be a Jesus Christ. And I want you to understand, without the Father God Almighty, there is no one like him. And without him, there could not be us. Without him, we are nothing at all. And I want you to understand something this morning. I want you to see and understand that God, the same God yesterday, today, forever, he will always remain the same. I'm talking about him today because it is all about him as a father. Lord, today is Father's Day, and I wanted to really express to God how much we love him and how much we exalt him, how much we lift him up and we magnify him, how much we want to thank him for all that he is and what he's about to do. And I want you to understand, I want to focus on a certain scripture today, John 3:16. Everyone knows that scripture. You know, growing up, my mother would teach me the scripture. She always gave me the importance of knowing the word of God. And I know in John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Oh, what love the Father has given unto us, that we will be called the sons of God." And I want you to understand today that because of God the Father, which made heaven and earth, because of him, he sent his only begotten Son, so that you and I can have life more abundantly, so that you and I can have deliverance, and we can be free from every generational curse. We can be free from every bondage. We can be free from every chain that is trying to hold us back into captivity and trying to lock us aside. Listen to this. God, I'm listening. I want you to understand the Father that we're talking about this morning. I want you to understand this. I'm talking about the God who took Moses into the land of Egypt to free his people. That's the God I'm talking about. The God that literally sent Moses into Egypt just to set God's people free. And the Bible said that the Israelites prayed. The Bible said that the Israelites interceded and they cried unto God. And the Bible also states that the Israelites cried out and said, "God, I ask of thee to take us from the enemy and take us from the hands of Pharaoh." I want you to understand something today. The same God that rescued Israel from Egypt is the same God that's rescuing you and I today. The same God that delivered Israel out of Egypt is the same God that has delivered us and is about to deliver us, as he did the Israelites. The same God that uses Moses and used Moses at that time to uphold that rod, and immediately the water parted so that the Israelites could get to the other side. And the Bible also declared and said that the water swallowed up the other Egyptians that were chasing after them. And I want you to understand this. The Father that understood the importance of protecting his children, protected Israel, and protected and shielded them. And I want you to understand something today. I want you to understand that even the same God that protected Israel from Egypt and from Pharaoh, the same God that protected Moses when he went forth and when he challenged, when the Lord used him to conquer the other warlocks that were standing there, that threw them. And I want you to understand this. If you read the book of Exodus, you get to understand that my God. I want you to understand something. When God used Moses, God made sure that Moses was well equipped. The Father, God Almighty, made sure that Moses was protected. And I want you to understand something this morning. I want you to understand that God is protecting you, and God will always protect you. Because the same God yesterday that protected the Israelites, the same God yesterday that protected Jeremiah, the same God yesterday that protected King David, the same God yesterday that protected Abraham, is the same God that is protecting you and I today. We're talking about the true Father of the nation. We're talking about the Father of the fatherless. Oh my God. Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you for the Father God Almighty, which made heaven and earth. I want you to understand something this morning. I am so blessed to be able to be called a son of God, a child of the King. I love when the songwriter says, oh yes, I'm a child of the King. His royal blood flows through my veins. Who is that we're talking about? We're talking about the God Almighty, which made heaven and earth, and the one that sent his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. And I want you to understand that God the Father resides in Jesus Christ, and God is Jesus Christ in the flesh. Listen to this. And I want you to understand something here. I want you to understand that when we look at what happened to the Israelites and how that Father, God Almighty, used Moses to rescue the Israelites out of Egypt, because the Israelites could not make it out on their own. They needed to be delivered, and they did not stop searching and seeking God for God to rescue them from out of Egypt. And what happened is that God heard the cry of the Israelites, and God woke up Moses, anointed Moses, and told Moses, you're going to go forth, and you're going to go and talk to Pharaoh so that Pharaoh can let my people go. And even Moses could not understand, how is it that such a small man like me could really cause a great and noble king to really let the people of God go? And God said to him, don't worry about that, because I'm going to give you my power. Oh my God, I want you to understand that Moses understood that even the very strength he had as human, as a mortal man, could not supersede, neither could it be looked at. You know, people don't understand that our strength is not strength at all, but God's strength is the strength of our life. And I want you to understand that Moses understood that. Moses understood that he needed the strength of God. He needed faith. He needed to have power. And he understood that the power that he was looking for, only God could have given it to him. And I want you to understand something here, that Moses went forth to the Israelites, and Moses went forth to Egypt and literally spoke to Pharaoh. And God himself told Moses, listen, I'm going to harden Pharaoh's heart. And even Moses understood that. So listen, I want you to understand that Moses realized that, listen, I'm going to obey you. Whatever you want me to do, Father God, I'm going to do it. Wherever you want me to go, I'll go. And whatever you want me to do, I'll do. And God told him, listen, you're going to put the rod that you have in your hand on the floor, and that rod is going to become a snake. And after that, that snake will eat up all the other snakes. And what I'm going to do, I want you to take that snake by the tail, and it will become a rod again. And if you read the book of Exodus, you get to understand what Moses did in that time. And I want you to understand something here. I want you to understand that, listen, the same God that used Moses to deliver his people is the same God that's about to use you to deliver his people. I don't understand why is it that sometimes we get to look at something and we know that God is calling us to do it, and we know that God wants us to do something, and we desire the strength of God, but we are not asking for it. I want you to understand that the importance of really submitting to the Holy Spirit, yielding to the Holy Spirit, and watch God do something miraculous for you. The same God that miraculously took Israel out of Egypt, out of slavery, out of generational curses, out of bondage, God is doing the same thing for you and I today. And for some of us that has been around and been at some places where you were locked up in captivity in the spirit, where you were blinded, I want you to understand that God is freeing your mind, God is freeing your spirit, God is freeing your heart. I want you to understand something this morning. I want you to understand that when you look at how Moses, God used Moses to deliver Israel out of Egypt, look at this. They came up, and Moses understood that the power that he had, only God could have given him that power. The anointing he had, only God could have given him that anointing. He understood that the power and the anointing that is upon him, that was upon his life, no man could have given it to him but the Almighty God. And Moses understood the importance of being in the presence of God. And I want you to understand that being in the presence of God, it takes a big role, and it causes us to have such great power. Because, see, sometimes we don't understand that we are weak, but he is strong. And whenever we find ourselves at that place where we understand how weak we are and that we can't do anything on our own, we get to understand the importance of really and truly being in the presence of God, just so that we can be stronger in the spirit and even stronger on the earth. And I want you to understand something. Moses went forth and Moses delivered God's people. But let's look at this. Let's look at what God did for Daniel when Daniel was thrown into the lion's den. Let's look at what happened there. Let's look at how Daniel was thrown into this lion's den because he was praying three times a day to a God that he could not see. But he believed that he was there. Because, you see, relationship brings faith, and your faith brings the victory. And I want you to understand that Daniel had a relationship with God. And Daniel understood the importance of having a relationship with God. And what happened with Daniel is that Daniel was praying for 3 times a day, knowing that in where he was, he could not pray to any other god but the god of the king, Darius, that was there. But listen to this. When Daniel was thrown into the lion's den, even the king Darius prayed for him and worried for him. And I want you to understand, God will cause your enemies to even pray for you and bless you. That's the Father that we have. Our Father will make our enemies become our footstool. Or Father God Almighty between heaven and earth will cause our enemies to come back and apologize for what they have done to you. Or Father God Almighty will cause even our enemies to come back and bless you. And I want you to understand something this morning. I'm not going to keep you long because today's Father's Day. I want you to go and take your wives, take your husbands out, to and the kids take your dads out. But I really want to bring you on this path, on this journey. Please come on this journey with me. My God, I feel the anointing. I want you to understand that Daniel, who was thrown in the lion's den, did not stop praying, even though he was told to stop praying. He did not stop praying. Why? Because he understood the importance of prayer. He understood the importance of being in relationship with God. He understood the importance of really being in the presence of God. And what happened? The king woke up the very next day and went down. And read the book of Daniel, you get to see it. He went down to that place, that cell, the dungeon, and saw that the lions did not touch him. Oh my God, Shandra Yonabosa. I want you to understand something. Even though God, the enemy has placed you in the lion's den, God is saying the lions cannot touch you. They will not devour you. They will not scratch you. They will not try to destroy your life. Neither will they kill you. They can't kill what God has already given purpose to. When purpose is on your life, there is no way on earth that the enemy will conquer, will rule, and will win you, because God has already given you the victory because you have purpose written all over you. When purpose is on your life, you will not be defeated. When purpose is on your life, you may be tossed down. You may be kicked to the side, but it is not over. When purpose is on your life, you will not die, but you shall live to declare the works of the Lord. When purpose is on your life, and you know that your Father God Almighty between heaven and earth is still alive and is still seated on the throne, you have victory, you have life more abundantly, and you are blessed beyond measures. I want you to understand something today. Daniel went through that. And as Daniel stood in the lion's den, not one lion touched him. And the Bible said in the book of Daniel that at that very moment when the king went down to see if he was all right, he was more than all right. He was blessed, he was untouched, and he was unmoved. And God is saying, you are blessed, you are untouched, and you are unmoved. And God wants you to know today that as he stood with even Daniel in the lion's den, he is standing with you right now in your lion's den that's happening in your life. I don't know where you are right now, but the same God that the Father God Almighty, which made heaven and earth, that delivered Daniel out of the lion's den, listen to this, is the same God that's delivering you from the lion's den. Now, I want you to look also, let's look at Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Even as you look in the book of Daniel, as you read further on, you get to understand that even Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that three Hebrew boys, Mandaba, Shandra, Yonabosa, that even went through a series of what we call literal, straight up attack, where they did not bow to the king. And they understood the importance of not bowing to any other god. And they told the king, they said, king, let me tell you something. I am not bowing to your god. I'm not bowing to you. I only bow to the one true God, which made heaven and earth. And even the king was so angry and upset. And what had happened was, at that time, they said, oh, so the king said, oh, you won't bow to any other god? Well, you won't bow to me? Huh? Well, okay, well, then turn up that fire because we're going to throw you in there. And I want you to understand that even then, Mandaba, Shanda Yerabosa, oh my God, I thank you, Jesus. At the very moment, they were thrown into the fiery furnace. And as they were thrown into the fiery furnace, the Bible in the book of Daniel tells us and tells us that at that very moment when they were thrown into the fiery furnace, that the king looked and they said, but I thought we threw only three inside of that fiery furnace. I don't understand, because I've seen a fourth person. Who is that fourth person? I want you to understand the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. The God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God of Israel, the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, listen to me. I'm talking about the God of Elijah, prophet Elijah, that called for fire. God stood with them even in the spirit. God stood with them even there in the physical. And I want you to understand, sometimes you may not see God standing there with you in the fire, but I'm telling you this, God is causing your enemies to see him standing with you in the fire. Listen to me and hear me well. The same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. The same God that stood with Israel and delivered Israel out of Egypt. The same God that stood with Daniel in the lion's den. The same God that stood with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fiery furnace is standing with you today. Thank you, honey. I want you to understand that. Huh? My God, I feel the Lord. I want you to understand this. I want you to really see it. I want you to know that God is standing with you. Your Father is standing with you. I'm not only talking about your physical father. And I love when the Bible says that even when, that David wrote this in the book of Psalms. He said, even when your mother and your father have forsaken you, I will not forsake you. I will not leave you. I will always be with you. David understood that this is the promise that God made to him. The covenant that we have with our Father in the heavens is greater than the covenant we have with our earthly father. I want you to understand that. I want you to understand that our earthly father can never come anywhere close to our heavenly father. If it wasn't for our heavenly father, we would not be here. If it wasn't for our heavenly father loving us and taking care of us and sending his only begotten son just so that we can have life and that so more abundantly. My God, then what would have happened? So I want you to understand today, I want you, wherever you are right now, I want you to give God thanks and give the Father God Almighty thanks for being the greatest Father, the deliverer, the sustainer, the way maker, the wheel in the middle of the wheel. Oh, of course, Jesus Christ is all that and more. But Jesus Christ even said it, that nobody can go to the Father except through him, because he valued his Father and he knows the value of his Father, God Almighty, and our Father too. Remember, we were Gentiles, but now we are God's children, chosen vessel. Gentiles that were saved, we were not literally born by blood Jewish, but because we were Gentiles, right? But because of the precious blood of Jesus Christ, we have been bought with a precious price, and we have been adopted into the family of God. I want you to understand this today, that the same God that is seated on the throne, that is seated on high, that is your Father, my Father, is the same God today and forever. I told you I didn't want to keep you long because this morning is Father's Day. And I said I don't want to keep you long, and I won't keep you long because now, see, maybe you come to a close of this service this morning. I want you to understand something here. I want you to understand this morning, that the same God yesterday is the same God today and is the same God forevermore. I know when we get to read and we read the Word of God and we look at the Old Testament. And as we look at the Old Testament and we look at even the New Testament, there is God written all over it. All over it, the Word of God stands strong. I want you to understand this morning, this afternoon, I want you to understand that our Father, God Almighty, which made heaven and earth, is still seated on the throne, and he still reigns forevermore. Jesus Christ, the Son of the Almighty God, is seated at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us. Then we have the Holy Spirit that literally came to take Jesus' place on this earth. The Holy Spirit is the one that is here with us every second of every minute of every hour of every day. The Bible says that Jesus told the disciples that the Holy Spirit will not come if I'm still here. So for the Holy Spirit to have come and made his way here, Jesus had to go back to his Father in heaven to intercede on our behalf. The Holy Spirit is here with us, and the Holy Spirit will always be here until the day of the rapture comes, where the Holy Spirit will be one again with God the Father back in heaven. Today, our Father's Day, let's just not only be appreciative of our earthly fathers, but like myself, an orphan boy who had no one else and that was tossed and pushed away by many, except God. Let us always look to God, the author and the finisher of our faith. The same God yesterday, today, and forever. The same God that protected us in our past and is protecting us today and will always protect us in the future. What good is it that I have done to deserve such a love, an undeniable love, an uncompromisable love? There is no love than the precious love of God the Father and Jesus Christ the Son. I want you to understand this morning that our focus must not only be upon our earthly fathers today on this earth, but may it also be upon our heavenly Father, God Almighty, which made heaven and earth. We have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, but because of the Lord God Almighty that sent his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to die on Calvary's cross, while we have life, and that's so more abundant. Don't you get it? The one true God, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God that raised Jesus Christ from the dead. It is because of him that we have life today. He sent his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, so you and I can live and have life. And that's so more abundant. Hallelujah, glory, glory, glory.
My daily bread.
lost without you, Lord? How can I be the best man of God that there is without you? How can I ever be the best son to you, Lord, without you? How can I be the best husband without you, Lord? How can I be the best father to my children? How can I be the best shepherd to the flocks that you have placed me over? I can't without you, Lord.
Oh,
that song. That song is so beautiful. I actually love that song. So lost, so lost without you. You know, wherever you are, I would actually love for you to just continue to just worship the Lord. Just give Him thanks, give Him glory, give Him praise. You know, I'm blown away by His glory. I'm even more blown away by His love. I was actually saying the other day to someone, the love that I see that the Lord gives to us is love, is a love that I've never ever seen before.
Thank you.
nothing ever seen on earth.
Lord, who can grasp your infinite wisdom?
I can't do it. This mind, this mortal mind of mine, cannot do it.
Who can fathom the depth of your love?
You are beautiful beyond description.
Majesty. Majesty. Worship is majesty. Unto Jesus be glory, honor, and praise.
So we exalt and lift up on high the matchless name of Jesus.
To thee we ascribe glory. To thee we ascribe honor. To thee we ascribe majesty and power.
Holy is the Lamb.
Holy is the Lord.
Glory,
honor,
majesty,
power.
The all-wise God.
The all-seeing God.
The all-knowing God.
We thank you for what you're about to do right now. Father, we ask of thee right now in Jesus Christ's name, even as I'm under this anointing, I ask of thee in Jesus' name that you'll touch the hearts of your people right now, God. Even as they're watching, touch them right now. Lord, we thank you for healing in their bodies. We thank you for, dear Lord God, for new open doors. We thank you, dear Lord, for touching them. Give them a fresh touch, my Lord.
My God, I feel the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus.
For all those who are even sick and is watching me right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, touch your children.
In Jesus' name.
We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for breaking every spirit of bondage from off their life that has been trying to hold them captive into the things of this world, into the things of sin. Destroy it now in the name of Jesus. Destroy it now in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for good news from the doctor, Lord. We thank you for academic excellence. We thank you for those who will be doing exams. We thank you that they'll pass with flying colors in Jesus' name. We thank you for filling your children with the Holy Spirit. They've been asking for having to really have a true encounter with you. Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, please, Lord, give them that encounter. Let your glory be upon them like never before.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus Christ's name. Open their eyes, Lord. Let them see clearly in the Spirit to understand clearly. Let your Holy Spirit free their spirits out of spiritual bondage and evil wickedness.
Lord, let them walk into your marvelous light.
Let them not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And let them be able to stand with authority and power to trample on the scorpion and to trample on the enemy. And let them know that there's no man to fear but you, Lord Jesus Christ, but God himself.
We should never fear one, any man on earth. We must only fear the Almighty God.
It is God that has the power, not man.
Father, we thank you right now for what you're about to do in Jesus' name.
Open the eyes of the blind and let them not be afraid to stand up for righteousness, for holiness, and for the right things. Let us stand upright for the truth of God, your word.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Right now in Jesus' name. Amen.
For those who are watching, I pray that the healing of God, the hand of God will touch you.
Healing will be upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
I don't know about you, but I just love to worship.
Oh, I love to worship. I love to worship.
I don't know who this is for, but it doesn't matter what you've done in your past week.
You know, I realize that sometimes the devil likes to bring up our pastoral lives, just to keep us there. Because I was too guilty of that. And the Lord has been delivering me from it. And I pray that He deliver you too, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Every past hurt, every past pain, everything that happened in your past that brought tears to your eyes and brought your heart to shatter. In Jesus Christ of Nazareth, there's not a broken piece that God cannot make. In Jesus' name. You know, I really want to thank you guys so much for tuning in this morning to this wonderful service. I don't know about you, but I know the Holy Spirit is here. He's still here, was here, will always be here. And you know what? I tell you this. I want you to understand that even for those right now, as a matter of fact, for those right now who you're watching, if you're here, you're watching, and you have never given your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, and you would love to do so, let me pray with you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, as they're about to give you that chance in their life, Father, let your Holy Spirit touch them right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. They'll never be the same again. Convict their hearts, Lord. Remind them of who they are and whose they are in you, Lord Jesus Christ. They are your children. They do not belong to the devil. They belong to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Every spirit of lies that has been going through their ears, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we shut you up right now. Because you are free. And the word of God says, whom the Son set free is free indeed. And we thank you for freedom right now in Jesus' name. We thank you that it's done in Jesus' name. Amen. For those who would really love to, after that such a powerful word this morning, you'd love to give. And you'd love to sow a seed into the ministry. Please remember that when you're giving, it's not that it goes in my pocket. Oh no, it goes into the building of the church, the forming of the church, and the expansion of the church, and even the spreading of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We may be small now, but I know for a fact God is about to do something even bigger. Because I feel it every single moment I feel it. And I want you to know this today, that God is still in the business of blessing His children. And for those who are about to sow and about to give, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I believe the information is on there. For those who want to cash out, for those who want to do the PayPal, you can go ahead and begin sow right now in Jesus' name. Father, as they are about to give, Lord, whatever they are about to give, return unto them tenfold in Jesus Christ's name. Father, open the floodgates of heaven and pour all your blessings upon them, Lord. Father, your word says, give and it will come back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall then give unto their bosom. Father, let people bless them. Lord, bless them. I'm talking about money coming in the mail, money showing up in their bank account without them even knowing it. Supernatural, miraculous. Lord, I believe in miracles and no, I believe in God. Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus for what you're about to do right now. For those who are watching, who are about to sow and is about to bless the ministry, Father, bless them like in abundance in Jesus' name. Take the stand up now to give and to sow into the ministry. And I pray that God will bless you back with what you give. Everything that you give may return to you tenfold in Jesus' name. For those who would love to go on our website, you can go on juniormedicministries.com. You get to read up a little bit about the ministry, what we believe in. Oh, we believe in God the Father, we believe in Jesus Christ the Son, we believe in the Holy Spirit. We believe in the Trinity anointing, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Blessed three in one. And I also would love for you to go on, or when you click, when you scroll down, you can see our logo, the dove. You hit the dove, it signifies the Holy Spirit. And remember, the Bible says in the Holy Spirit ascended upon Jesus as a dove. That's what happened. So right now, I would love for you, you can go on there, Junior Medic Ministries, I believe that's also on there. You can click on that link, scroll down to the bottom of the page, and you'll see the dove. You can hit the dove, and you can also donate into the building of the church, which is purchasing our own building. And do not be scared of what you see. I believe in miracles. Catherine Kuhlman, when she was walking the face of this earth, used by God, she had $5 for her name to give to her assistant to go and to get a building, chairs, and the best piano for a young woman that was traveling with her called Helen. And she told her assistant, this is $5. And I'm giving you this $5. Oh my God, I feel different. And I want you to take this $5 and I want you to go and I want you to find the best place there is that we can find for the service. And I want you to get even the best chairs because, listen, I want you to even get the best piano for Helen to play. And she said to her, to her assistant, Catherine Kuhlman said to her assistant, God deserves big, and we're going to go big for the Lord. And we at Breakthrough Church, we are going big for God. And Catherine Kuhlman said this. Catherine Kuhlman said, the same God that literally doubled and multiplied the food for the 500 is the same God that's multiplying that $5 in the building of her ministry. And today, I believe in miracles. It will take a miracle for this building to come, and I believe in God that this miracle will happen. The same God that did it for Catherine Kuhlman, the same God that did it even for feeding the 500, is the same God that's going to 5,000, is the same God that's doing it today for me. I believe in miracles. And I want you to believe in miracles. That's why you need to pray more. The more you pray, the more you find yourself expecting miracles. We must expect miracles. If we don't expect miracles, then what's the use of us praying? Because if we're not expecting miracles, then we don't have any faith. We must be able to have faith and to expect miracles. And so, as you look at the figure that we are expecting God for, please believe and believe in us. We saw the building. I believe there's a video on there that you can see what we are about to purchase. You get to see. I know you'll love it. So I'd love for you to go on there. Whatever you feel, and always remember your donation is different from your offering and your tithe. You know, if you want to sow to the ministry, it's different than your donation. You can go ahead and you can go and donate to the building of this ministry. And to buy that building. And so far, people have been coming on board and giving what they can. And we welcome whatever it is. It could be small and it could be great. We are thankful for it. We give God thanks for you. Before I close, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we ask of you to touch your children right now. Bless them, Lord, as they're about to give in the building of the ministry. Bless them, Lord, with double. Bless them with abundance. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we let your Holy Spirit be upon them right now, and they will never be the same. Jesus Christ, amen. Remember, your breakthrough is now in Jesus' name. We love you, and thank you so much for tuning in this morning, this afternoon, for service. God bless you.